What's up, y'all? It's your girl Sequoia. If you're new here, welcome. If you're returning, thanks for tuning back in. Setup is a little different. Today's video is going to be kind of like a maintenance vlog, kind of just me trying to figure out some things. I'm not really an insecure person, I would say, but I've been just really struggling with a little bit of my under eye darkness, and I feel like as I've been getting older, it's just been getting a little bit worse. And all, like, you know, Botox and fillers, there are things that are out there cosmetically that I can do, but I've been just trying to do what I can on my own. Creams, sleep, more water, putting a spoon in the freezer and then putting it to your eyes. I've tried numerous things to help with it and nothing seems to help. But I do notice that when I do my eyebrows and when I wear lashes, they kind of, the added contrast of my eyebrows and lashes kind of take away from the darkness being so prominent, and it helps. So I decided that maybe if I do microblading and start wearing maybe like lash clusters, like lash extensions, or just getting my lashes done, would kind of just help a little bit with my confidence around the dark eye circles. So from somebody that doesn't really wear like makeup and all, you know, those type of things like every day, I thought this would help. So if you're interested in just seeing me do some DIY lashes, some lash clusters, and then seeing a little bit of the behind the scenes process of microblading, make sure you stay tuned and continue watching. If you don't mind, please like my video, please subscribe and join the family. It will help my channel out a lot. And without further ado, let's get into the video. So the day I decided to film this, my package came. Let's open it together for the first time. This is from Veyesbeauty. This is what it looks like. I ordered the newbie 5-second set. This set is not too crazy. It's kind of more on the wispy side, not mega volume, nothing crazy like that. It was packaged very nicely, has some instructions on the back of the package, and as you can see, it came from China. After unpackaging it, we have the lash book. It's 3 rows of 16, 314, 312, 310, and 2 rows of 8 millimeters. The pink container is the lash bond with the lash seal. The white container is lash remover, and it does come with tweezers to clamp your lashes and the clusters together. Overall, I'm super excited to get started on these. So let's get into it. I'm taking the lash seal, the lash bond, or no, it's the lash seal. The lash seal, which is the black, and I am coating my lashes. I'm being careful to get it primarily where the lash clusters are going to stick. And I'm also being very careful to make sure I really, really coat the inner part of my eye and the outer part of my eye with the glue, because those are the areas for me that fall off first. So just really saturating my eyes with the glue. And a quick tip, I use my finger and pull my skin of my eye up gently so that my eye is perched at the top. And then I'm also going to take some of the sealant on the lash itself, which also is extra glue to make sure these things stay on. I'm starting with the 16, and I will have my lash map on the screen. I'm starting with a 16 first, and I'm putting that on the outer part of my eye. And I like to use the back of the tweezers to kind of like push it into my real eyelash. And this just kind of helps make sure the things stick. And this is the second 16 that I'm going in with. And then this is going to be a 14. And this process is really redundant. You know, you do have to take your time. As you can see, some of them do want to show out. They don't want to stick, they want to show out, but with practice it becomes pretty easy. I'm taking another 14 and I'm putting that right next to it. And also what I like to do is kind of overlap them just a little bit. This is the third 14, and I like this lash map honestly just because I put the longer lengths on the outside and the shorter lengths on the inside. This is the 12, and I like the way it makes my eye shape look, but obviously you can do whatever lash map fits your eye. And then on the inner corner, we just ending it off with the 10, and you can see that inner part had a good amount of glue. We want that to stick. We definitely do. So now I'm just pushing them all in, and this is what this eye looks like. And you can see there's a huge difference. The bad bee is loading, okay? This was such a good idea. I just hope these things last. I went off to do the other eye, and now we're gonna bond them together, which is this white side. So I go in first, right where the, I don't even know what part of my eye to call this, but right at the base. Yeah, base is the word. Base of where the clusters are, where I stuck it on my lash line, and I really, really worked the product in there. Then I'm gonna take the tweezers that came in the package, and I'm going to rub the bond in between it. And what I'm gonna do with this is then clamp the lashes and my real lashes together. This is gonna help them also stay on longer. And then the glue is going to get sealed in with my lashes, and the clusters and everything is just supposed to melt together. And I do this twice. You see how it's kind of sticking there? That means that the products that I put on there that first initial time is gone. So I'm gonna go in there, put some more on that tweezer, and then I'm gonna go in and make sure I really do the inner part of my eye, the middle, the outer part, just make sure everything is fully clamped and stuck together. And as you can see, there's already a dramatic difference in my facial features with these lashes. So far, so good. For you guys, it's just gonna be a second, but tomorrow we gonna get into the microblading for my eyebrows. I'm so excited. Good morning. It is November 9th, day of my appointment. You can see these eyebrows are non-existent. I've just pulled up to Aubrey's spot to go ahead and get these eyebrows done. I'm excited. I'm running a little bit late. I'm hoping she allows me to like set up so I can do like a cute little time lapse for y'all. But if not, y'all know after the appointment, I'll give you the details. Lashes are still on, still intact. I slept very comfortably with them. They look very natural, which is usually what I like to go for anyhow. So let's go get these eyebrows done. We're about to begin. I'm just running to the restroom before she takes this piece off. It's a numbing for my eyebrows. She did make me sign some like paperwork, like how you go to the doctor's office, just letting, I guess just asking for like signature, like, hey, instructions were given to me. I'm allowing X, Y, Z person to operate on me, or not operate, work on me, whatever the terminology is, signature type stuff. We sat for a minute and she gave me the rundown of what to expect with the process of doing the eyebrows and the healing process and the timeline for the touch-up. So this has been on my face now for about 30 minutes. It's 10:47. She put it on me at like 10:08. So she's getting ready to take it off. I'm just gonna use the restroom and then I'm gonna set you guys up. She did agree for me to do a time lapse and show you guys the process. So super excited. This is the finishing product for now anyway. In what is it, 4 to 6 weeks, 4 to 8 weeks, come back for a potential touch up. But if they look anything like this still, we may not need it. Thank you to Aubrey.
I am officially finished and this is what they look like. She did put a sealant over them, so in case you see like a little sheen to it, it looks glossy. It's a protectant to help them heal and to kind of help the color stick to my skin and like seep in. I overall would rate this process an 11 out of 10, simply because it was done by the best, honestly. Like, I love Aubrey Down. She does my Brazilian waxes too. She does do lashes, body sculpting, numerous services. And usually when you hear of somebody that is like the jack of all trades, you kind of get a little suspect, because it's like, are you really good at all those things, or are you just doing it to do it? But she is so good at everything. Love her down bad. The overall cost for this procedure was $400. $400 for both eyebrows. She mapped them. She did like all the legwork to make sure that they're even. The process was seamless. Every step of the way, she was like going over it with me, asking me if I liked it, what I think. She swatched a couple colors on my forehead. I don't know if you can tell from the time lapse, but she swatched like four colors on my forehead and allowed me to like pick which one I felt was best, and then, you know, gave her professional opinion. She also gave me goodie bag wipes every 1 to 2 hours. I'm supposed to wipe my eyebrows to keep like the lymphatic drainage off, and then I have an ointment, I have razor, you know, any stragglers come in to, you know, take it off. And then she gave me like this really cute like card of like the overall process and what my eyebrows are going to look like over the course of them healing. I can't go to the gym for 3 to 5 days, boo. But I mean, I understand why. You don't want sweat and bacteria to get in it. It is essentially like a tattoo. It is an open wound. It literally didn't take me too much time. My appointment was at 10. We got started about 10:08, 10:10. Doing each eyebrow took her maybe like 10-ish minutes or so. And then she did touch-ups. And overall, it was just a great procedure. I love them so much. Like I said, I'm going to come back in about 5-ish weeks to do my touch-up, just because I'm moving next month as well, so I will not be in this area. So I'm going to do my touch-up at like the 5-6 week mark. I don't know if I'm going to need it, but she does says it's recommended, so, you know, as it heals, if any pigment moves or falls out, I can come back and get it touched up, no problem. So shout outs to Aubrey. I hope you guys like this type of content. I don't know, I really just wanted to record this and just let you guys, you know, like see what the process is. Maybe there's other people who are considering doing a procedure like this and just want a little bit more information on it. Aubrey owns Howe Lovely, like that's her business name. She's in Sebring, Florida. She's great. Like I said, she does numerous services and she's very good at what she does. She's a very smart and knowledgeable woman. I love her. And since I've been living over here for Sebring, like she's literally the only one I come to for like any type of cosmetic type procedures, I guess. So that's it for this video. I hope you guys liked. I will give you guys updates and so on so forth in videos. I'm going to be going to New York next weekend, so there'll be a vlog on that, so you guys will see my eyebrows as they heal. If you did like this video, you like this type of content, please considering subscribing, joining the family. Please like this video, and I would honestly like to know your comments below. What do you guys think? Do you guys think that the lashes and the eyebrows can help with my under eye darkness? I feel like throughout parts and bits of the video, like you can see it more, but like in outside lighting, it's not that bad. But you guys let me know what you guys think. Until then, see you in the next one. Bye.